So ready? I used to speak fast, so stay concentrate. Usually presentations are boring. Nobody wants to hear someone talking for 1 hour. So feel free to interrupt me with questions or whatever you want. That it's going to be much better if there is a real discussion rather than me talking. Maybe before we start, I have to warn you something. I really love my job at Odoo. I mean, super cool. We have an impact of millions of people and the company is different every 2 years. It's very fun. But there is one thing I really don't like. There is one thing that I really hate in my job, and it's to-do slides. It's boring. I don't like PowerPoint. So this time I decided that I will exploit children. I mean, it's always good to exploit children. Specifically, I exploited my children to do the slides. So I apologize for that, and here it is. Let's go. So I'm Fabien, for the ones who don't know me. And I'm the founder and the CEO of Odoo. Okay, we're living a shitty period. I mean, Odoo has always had a very strong culture where we operate in a certain way and we work together and so on. But now with the lockdown, we have the risk of diluting this culture because everyone is at home. They don't used to work the way we work together and learn from the others and so on. So I wanted to do this meeting so that you have the opportunity to meet others and be where we are, because when we are at home, we don't always want to disrupt someone, to ask questions, so when we are away at the office, everyone talks all the time, so it's very different. So I know it's hard to live from home, but in every crisis there are opportunities. And our opportunity for this crisis is that the world is moving toward our direction. I mean, company needs to be digitalized, they need to be able to work online. So there is a huge demand on Odoo. We are growing super fast because of that, because we need to cover the service for the demand. So it's not going to be easy, because at the same time we are all at home with the lockdown, and at the same time we have to grow very fast because people need us to transform the company and move to the new era of digitalization. So that's our opportunity, and it's not going to be easy, because when you grow at that pace, of course, so you have to imagine we are 1,300 now, something, and we grow by 70% per year. So you have to imagine that in 1 year, 40% of the company will have less than 1 year experience at Odoo. So it's a lot of small people with huge responsibilities, because we have to deliver thousands of customers that we'll put into production. So in order for all the things to work, because when you have so many new people with so much responsibilities, there will be a lot of problems. There will be a lot of shitty things and problems here and there. And it will work only if we all do it to ensure that it works. If we all retrousse les manches, if there is an issue, we will help everyone. We will help each other. We will coach the new people. We will, and all the things. So it's very important that we all walk in the same direction to be sure that we succeed this challenge. Okay, just to give you an idea, we are talking about 70% growth per year. Nobody wants, really knows what it is, but imagine that today we are 1,350. 70% growth means that soon we'll be 2,200. 1 year after, 3,700. 1 year after, 6,000 people. That gives you an idea of the speed. What does it mean? It also means that probably nearly everyone in this room will have to be team leader within 2 years. I mean, we have to support all these new people, we have to train them. And the ones who will not be the team leader will be expert, coach, and so on. So it also forces us to be sure that everyone evolves very, very quick in order to tackle this challenge. Clear? And so I have a few tips to succeed on that. The first one is, it's very important that we are all very responsible. That's something we have done very well in the past. We have always been very responsible. So when there is an issue, there is nobody that says, oh, it's not my job, it's not my role. You should check with the development department, because when you grow at that pace, there will be issues everywhere. It's important that we all try for the company to be better. Even if it's not your responsibility, I think when you notice someone that's not working, someone that is frustrated, or an issue in your process, or someone who doesn't have a task to do today, it's your responsibility also to be sure that it improves. And if you can't do it because it requires a development, check with the guy who will do the development. We should not just forward problems to others. Because there will be, growing at that pace and the challenge we have of helping thousands of companies will require a lot of responsibility of us to be sure that things work well. And the second thing, challenge we'll have is that we need you to evolve very fast, because in 2 years there will be 3,700 people in the company. So that means that we will need the team leaders or the experts or the smart guys of tomorrow, and they are here. So we need to learn very quick. That's also one of the reasons why I don't know if there is business analyst in the room, but we give projects very fast. You probably have already 5-10 projects assigned, because it's the fastest way to learn. And we want people to learn very quick. We ask salespeople to do a lot of calls and demos so that they practice a lot and they evolve very quick, because we need everyone to evolve quick. We train the managers to say mistakes are okay. People can do failure, it's okay. We train the manager to not shout on someone when something's wrong. We accept that. Of course, it's human. Nobody is happy when something gets wrong, but that's part of our culture, and we have done very good in the past on that. We say to everyone that, okay, you can do mistake, go for it, move forward. You don't need a validation to decide something. You don't need to talk to your manager to improve something. If you notice something that's wrong, take the responsibility for you and try to improve it. Because it's the fastest way to learn, and evolution is more important than doing mistakes. And that's the culture we try to keep. And the reason why I'm doing this presentation today is that I want to be sure that we continue having the same approach. Clear? No question? All right. The third thing is autonomy. When we grow at that pace, you'll probably not always have someone to tell you what to do. So we rely on everyone to be autonomous because we have no other possibility. We have to. And if someone doesn't have a task or doesn't know what to do, be sure that you check with a team leader also. But basically, the idea is that you can decide whatever you want. So we need people to be autonomous, because you try also to have not too many management layers. If you look at our team leaders or managers today, the main things they do is to coach people, to review, to help, to do pull requests for the developers, to do pipeline review and demo training for the salespeople, working on the methodology for the consultant. But only a few people have to do management of people. And we try to keep that. We don't want people that do planning and budget and things like that. And the only way to work and to continue growing at what we are doing without having all these management tasks is to have people that are autonomous, that don't need someone that tells them a planning, that don't need someone that tells them that gives them a budget. And we want to keep that. So we need you to feel free to behave the way you would behave if it is your company. Okay? In order to grow at that pace, the fourth thing that will be important is to focus on what's valuable. That's probably one of the strengths, and one big part of the success of Odoo up to now is that we have been very good at focusing on what matters and not spending time on details and going to the point and have a lot of common sense. It sounds simple, logic, but only a few companies have that much common sense and ability to focus and to cancel things that are not valuable. And we are very good at that. The thing is, now that we have a lot of people in the lockdown that joined recently the company, we have to be sure that it's still the case, and we have to be sure that we continue in that direction. What does it mean? It means that you always have to understand what is the strategy of Odoo, where we want to go, what is important for us, and be sure that we move to that direction. For instance, if you are a developer, it's not about doing cool technical stuff. It's about building things that matter for the customer. Usually it's cool technical, but we don't do things for the pleasure of developing. We do things that should always matter for the customer. It's the same for a salesperson. The role of a salesperson is to make the technology affordable, understandable, so that people understand and see how they can transform the company to get more value. And the role of the service team is to be sure that the software gets affordable to people, so that we can do projects faster and cheaper. So that more companies and more SMEs can benefit from a technology they would never have dreamed before. And we always have to think and continue in that direction. That means we have to do choice. You have to decide what's valuable, what's not, from time to time, because your time is limited and you will have to allocate it on the right things. Is it clear? If you don't know, if you feel like, I don't know if I should do this or that, just ask, talk to your team leader or me or anyone in the company, and we can provide guidance on that. And the fifth tip is that we want to, it's okay to have a lot of challenges and responsibility. It's okay to have consultant that after a few months already manage several projects with a real responsibility on the project. It's okay to have developers that are alone in the task. The team helps, but they have the full responsibility of the task. It's okay to have salespeople who do the meeting on their own. Usually in traditional company, you have three persons, the technical sales that do the demo, the sales that do the relationship, and the SDR that schedule the phone calls and so on. At Odoo, one guy does everything because it's more efficient, and because we are more efficient, it reflects to a lower price to our SMEs. But we need everyone, but it's okay to have challenges and complexities and have autonomy, but it has to be, we all want to work in a good working environment. It has to be fun. We need a friendly atmosphere where everyone is happy to work. And for that, we should fight against the corporate nature of the people. I don't know why, but people tend to behave like corporate guys when they get a job. It's like in their personal life, they would never do something, but once they have the title of being employee, they act differently. Not everyone, but some. And so we have to fight against that. And in order to fight against that, I will give you some example of yesterday. At least I received them yesterday. I don't know if it's from yesterday. That the thing we should avoid in order to be sure that the working environment remains cool and everyone feels free to be open and transparent and to help others. And that is, I don't know if you know Anthony Le Suisse, it's our CTO. He's far from someone very formal. when you will meet him today, you will understand. And that is an email from one of the new employees that wrote to Anthony. I skipped the whole email in order, but it's, "Dear Mr. Le Suisse, many thanks in advance for your response." And the whole email was like that. And Anthony thought it was a salesperson from another company. And then he noticed that it was a salesperson working at Odoo. And then he said, "Whoa, we are becoming corporate." And those are the kind of things, nobody wants to work in that kind of, it's not to bash on this guy. Huh? I mean, when you are new, you don't know what to do in the company, but. I'm just saying that it's okay to be yourself, and we want everyone to be yourself. It's okay to come with shitty slides like this in the presentation if you like it. We should behave for the good of our employee, for the good of our customer. That's the only thing that matters. And we should try to think, how should I behave like an employee? Nobody cares about that. Okay? And I have another one like this, and I hope the person is not in the room, but I anonymized it. That is Alexander Fellner, is the team leader of the direct sales team. It's I don't know if you know him, but it's a nounours, a very friendly guy, and so on. And so someone of his team said, "Good to hear that," with a smiley. I said, "Okay, if you have done question, don't hesitate." And then, I thought you were Fellner for a second, and actually he is Fellner. And I was like, "Did I just send a smiley to my manager?" And so he answered, "Yes, I am your manager, but it's okay to send me a smiley." So don't be afraid. I'm very sorry, I got confused. Well, sorry, I cannot send a smiley to my manager. Bref. No, it's okay. I mean, we want a working environment where everyone feels comfortable. And I think it's important to understand that there is manager, there are people who decide like me, but we don't think we are manager. We believe we are at your service rather than the opposite. We do everything we can to be sure that all teams work better. So you shouldn't see people like manager. One thing, I don't know if there are salespeople here, you probably know Sébastien, the head of the sales. Excite Sébastien, just tell him that he's your N plus one or N plus two. N plus two. He hates that when someone says, "No, that's not the way you should see it." Okay? So those are the small details, but it's important. Of course, we have to be professional. If our customer expects us to be well-dressed, we will be well-dressed. If our customer is in the sports, we can go with a short. But it's important that we keep being friendly, keep being open. We should work as a team, not like colleagues of a big corporation. And it's important because the more we'll grow, the more people will tend to behave like they should behave in a big company. And I think we should keep the mindset of a startup. Even though we have the power of a big company, which is cool sometimes, we can do big marketing campaign, recruit a lot of developers if needed. It's important that we keep being who we are and behave the way we would have behaved for our normal life. I mean, at the end, we spend 1/3 of our life at work, so it better have to be cool. Okay, clear? So why do we do Odoo? We already told you that, but I like to repeat because I told you that what's important is to focus and build things that are valuable. So what's valuable for us is to, and I used to explain Odoo this way. Imagine a mechanic that doesn't have tools. So it could be the best mechanic in the world. You give him a car that is completely broken and he will fix the car in a few minutes. The guy is super smart, you know, all the car models. He's a great guy and he's really the best mechanics, you know. But if you don't give him tools, he will be very bad. I mean, he will take hours just to unscrew something, or even for himself, it's going to be very bad. He will be demotivated, frustrated, depressed. After having months of doing things without the tool, he could be depressed. And the thing is, in most of the SMEs, they don't have tools. In most of the SMEs, you still have accountants that record everything manually. You still have the recruiters that spend 30% of their time scheduling meetings. You know, first interview, second interview, then the manager is not available, and the candidate is not available. 30% of the time of HR in traditional company is just to schedule meetings. I mean, it's boring. Nobody wants to do that. They probably have more value at doing other things, like talking to people, explaining things, and so on. So most of the SMEs, they don't have tools because they couldn't afford, 5 to 10 years ago before Odoo, nobody could afford having a fully integrated management system, ERP like SAP, because a lot of them, they don't know it's affordable. They think they don't like IT or they're not good in IT. They think it's not accessible, it's too expensive. But the thing is, in a lot of small to mid-sized companies, they have no tools. If they need a reporting, they don't have the data. If there are a lot of people recording data manually, if they have a purchase manager, you know, 30% of the time of a purchase manager is to do the follow-up of this, what they purchased, just to call vendor. Will it arrive tomorrow? Are you sure? Just to be sure that the manufacturing line doesn't get broken. But 30% of the time, it's just to do follow-up of things they purchased. I mean, you can automate a lot by email and follow-up and so on. So we can really help these guys do more in less time. And that's what we do. We provide the tools for the employees to do more in less time so that they can do more valuable things, less boring things, less repetitive tasks that we can automate, less reporting that are accessible to everyone directly in the system, less looking for something if you need to, I don't know, a small company, if they have to build a website, they will look for a designer, that will look for a developer, they will do a project and it's going to cost you 20,000 euro. And we want them to get everything, all the tools they need ready, accessible, so that they can benefit from them and do marketing, and recruitment, and websites, and logistics very easily. And that is very important. And I think this core mission, which is to help employees at work to do more in less time, and I'm really emphasizing on employees because a lot of management software are designed for managers. I mean, they have beautiful dashboards, manager will like them, they buy them, but at the end, the employees suffer from using them. Our mission is completely different. We want every employee to be more efficient. We want to give good tools to people working in SMEs. And this reflects on all our departments. Obviously, in the R&D department, it's about building the features that matter to them. It's about being able to automate part of their job. It's about having the software that does what they need at the right time. Or having a software that is fast so that they don't have to click and wait every time they click with a loader. So for the R&D, it's about building the product that allows these guys to have access to this feature that helps them do their job. But for the sales and the service too, it's the same. For the salespeople, part of the goal and the responsibility of salespeople is to make the technology affordable. They do a lot of demonstration because people don't know what they can do. They don't know that they don't have to. Most of the manager, they think they are used to work the way they use the work. They can't imagine that you can do better. They can't imagine that you can save 30% of the time of your recruiter or 30% of your time of your purchase manager. And so we need the salespeople to educate the market, to do demonstration, to show to small directors how they can operate differently, how, what's the value of deploying Odoo. And we also need the consultant to deploy it efficiently. I mean, there is the value, but there is a large transformation for a company who wants to use Odoo. They have to work. The things that they used to do manually, now it's automated, but they have to do it in the system. So we also need the consultant to help in the transformation of the company. So we all operate in the same way. is to be sure that the SMEs run better and the employees of the SMEs can do more in less time. So that their time will be more used at valuable things rather than repetitive and administrative things. Clear? And that drives everything. Often when we are, should we do this or that, it's always about, does it help our employees or the employees to perform better? And how we will get to that point? So that's a reminder, you probably know how we work, but basically we have two products, so the community, used by millions of users. It's an old slide, but it's a thing, it's 7.4 million of users now. And or the product that brings money, which is Odoo Enterprise, which is a set of features on top for the community. It's what we call an open core business model. It's quite cool because, I mean, we have an impact of millions of users. There is not a lot of companies who could say, I have an impact of millions of users. And not a small impact. I mean, it's employees at work. So it's one third of their time. We spend one third of our time at work where they do something. So we have a strong impact of millions of users because we are open source. If we wouldn't be open source, we would have an impact of thousands of users, but not millions of users. So it's also great to know that. But this is also a strong constraint because the revenue we get is only a small part of what we do. It's only the red part compared to the purple part. 20% of what we develop only generates revenue. So that also puts us a strong constraint on us, which is to operate at a different level. We have to be less expensive. We have to be faster on everything we do because we don't have the large budget and revenue per user that another vendor would have if it wouldn't be open source. So we have to work with large volumes. We have to operate in much larger volumes than the other to compensate also the small price we get per user. Okay. So even though we do have a lot of services, it's maybe one third of the consultant in the company. Our job is a software vendor. So what matters for us is to have people use our software because 82% of our revenues come from the subscription of the software and partnership, and only 18% is one shot. So the basic idea of the service is not to generate revenue from services. We don't care about the revenue for services. The reason why we do service our customer is to help them transform the company so that they can use the software. Because at the end, what matters for us is the subscription of the, that's what makes it go, the subscription of the software. So it's the same. The service is not there to sell services. It's just there to help user use the platform, which is also goes to the same direction. Clear? Okay. The way we distribute that, we have two big departments, direct and indirect. In our sales department, we have five sub-sales departments. In direct, we have salespeople, direct sales. They do demonstration to customer. They educate the directors. As I said, most of the companies, they don't know they can operate better. They work like that since years, and they don't even think it can be better. So in order to show them and project them in the future on the way they could operate if they have or do, the direct sales team, we have the direct sales team. For the ones who are not from a sales department, sometimes you imagine a sales like a vendeur de tapis, rug seller. It's not that at all. We call them actually business advisors because that's what they do, they advise. They explain, they educate, they do demonstration, they talk with the CFO to explain them how to generate and do their accounting. They talk with the logistic guys in order to explain what's wrong in their process, how we can improve. That's the role of a salesperson. So it's like a consultant, but with an objective of target. And then once they sold the project is given to a customer success team who is responsible for the customer for the long term, for the 20 years to come. They will use the software, they will have to upgrade, they might have issues from here and there. And that's the job of the customer success team, is to ensure that these guys remain happy and they don't have issues in the path. That's the direct, that's the customer we work directly with. But we also have a team that manage indirect customer because 50% of our revenue come from the indirect, 50% from the direct. And there we have three teams, partnership recruitment. They recruit new partners or companies who will sell services on the two. And once we have new partners, company who will sell services, we have account managers, and account managers are like sales directors, except that their teams is not employees, but partners. And so every account manager has a small team of partners, and their job is to make them become better, is to make them evolve so that they deliver better service at an affordable price, to explain the implementation methodology, the way we handle customer and all the things. So Their job is the same, except they don't work for the inside of Odoo, they work for the ecosystem of Odoo, of all the partners. And once the partners sold the project and delivered the project, we assigned to another team, which is the same as this one, but for the indirect customer success, we ensure that the customer has a point of contact, the customer of a partner has a point of contact in the long term, so that if they get issues along the way, we handle them. So that's the way we will distribute our services and software. It's basically our sales department, so you always have these five. And in every company we have, whether it's in Hong Kong, in Dubai, in India, in San Francisco, they all have the same structure, these five sales departments. Our market. So, you know, sometimes we talk about the large companies we deployed at Danone, at Ego, at XKey, at large companies. But the thing is, the large companies is a saturated market. They all have a software. 80% of the large companies already use SAP or Oracle. So it's a replacement market, which is very complex. But in the lower part, in the small and the mid-sized company, the equipment rate is less than 18%. So basically, the small companies, they have nothing. They have Winbooks for their accounting. They have Trello or MailChimp to send email, but they have nothing integrated. Why? Because they couldn't afford having integrated management software. It was too expensive for them before. It was too messy and complex. Those software are bloated, unless until Odoo arrived. And so the majority of our market is the small and mid-size. So we also have a department that works for the large ones. We started that 1.5 years ago. They have a lot of success, actually, because we operate differently. The large companies like that, our value proposition. But the core and the focus of Odoo remains the small and mid-sized companies. That's where we can have the most impact. And if we have to summarize the strategy, it's two things. We are complete. So we do basically from accounting, inventory, manufacturing, CRM, HR, point of sale, basically everything. And we want to make it affordable. And affordable is not just about the license or the subscription price. It's also about all salespeople that democratize the technology. They are good at explaining the way it works, at making it understandable for people that are not IT-minded. But it's also about the service. Affordable is about is being able to do the project in 3 months rather than 3 years. It's or 30,000 euros rather than 300,000 euros. So it's also about the implementation service and so on. But basically, everything we do, our core focus is these two values. Make it be sure that the software satisfies the need of the user, complete, and make it affordable and accessible in terms of price, in terms of easy to transform the company and change. That's the strategy. If we look at the market, they have two types of players. You have the ERP players. They have a lot of features. They can do a lot of things. In this category, you'll have SAP, Microsoft Dynamics, Oracle. And because they have a lot of features from sales to manufacturing and so on, they are also very expensive. They are valued a lot. People are willing to pay millions of euros to get SAP running. So they have a lot of revenues per user. On the other hand, you have the single apps player, MailChimp to send emails, Slack for communication, Trello for task management, Winbooks or QuickBooks for your accounting, and things like that. Usually these guys have one app, but they are much easier in terms of usability. UX is user experience, their user experience is easier. And so they don't have a lot of revenue per user, the revenue per user is low, but they have an ability to attract a lot of users because it's simple. The thing that makes Odoo unique is because we played on these two levels. We are one of the rare solutions of the market that can do everything, so we are complete, like the ERPs. We even go further than the traditional ERPs because usually traditional ERPs don't have point of sale, e-commerce, business intelligence like spreadsheet integrated. Usually they use different software that they connect because they don't do everything. So we are very rich in terms of features. And on the other hand, we are also very simple, like the single app players. You could start online with a few clicks, and the price is transparent, and the software is not that complex to use. And the thing that makes us different than the other is that the single app player, they tend to improve in usability. The large players like SAP, they improve in terms of revenue per user. They bring more value, they benchmark themselves against the others. We have an ability to evolve diagonally. for a technical reason, is like every time we do something on the Do It applies to all our application. We don't have to improve every application. Like when we did the mobile app of Odoo, all our application became mobile. We didn't have to develop a mobile for the CRM and then the sales. The others, they have to do that because they are not well integrated like us. So basically they don't evolve fast in the web or in the mobile interface because it means that all the application have to be rebuilt. But when we did one thing at Odoo, all our apps directly works perfectly. And it's the same for everything. Once we released the website builder, we did a beautiful website builder, it became the front end for all our other application. So our sale application get an e-commerce, our recruitment application they get job offers online. And the more we improve the website builder, the more it brings value to recruitment application because job offers are beautiful. And so we have an ability to grow diagonally. We improve one thing, but it impacts the value of all the other applications. And that's the reason why we are unique. And theoretically, the revenue is the number of users you can get multiplied by the revenue per user. So it's the surface of the rectangle. So on the paper, because we are still small, our approach can drive us to a very good revenue. And I said that our challenge is to be complete. We help the user do what they need, all the users in the company, but also to be affordable. Part of the price of being affordable is the pricing of the subscription. And this is the price of the main competitor on the market, SAP, NetSuite, Microsoft. They run at $180 per user and per month. Odoo is at 25. That gives you an idea, it's like 7 times less than the others. There is, and in order to explain to customers how inexpensive it is, I used to compare that to the coffee. If you have to offer the coffee to your employee, I mean, an employee drinks on average 2 cups of coffee per day, and you have to pay the price of the small plastic cup and the milk and the sugar and the coffee machine. If you factor everything, that costs you a bit more than $1 per employee per day. That basically is $25 per user and per month, which is the price of Odoo. And both are good. I mean, both boost the productivity of employees. But that shows with the impact we can get is buying Odoo is like buying a coffee machine for your employees. And it shows how inexpensive we made it. So I talked mostly about the small and the mid-sized companies. Now let's talk about the larger ones. So I said that 2 years ago, we started to work on large corporation. It's not the main focus, so it's not the focus of our R&D or marketing, but it's still the focus for sales and services because we have a massive opportunity. I mean, large companies have bloated system. It's a messy market where people pay millions of dollars for things that doesn't work. So we have a massive opportunity to change that and we come with common sense implementation service and good product. So let's have a look at the market. If you ask a buyer what's important for you when you want to choose an ERP, he will tell you 6 different things. One is the industry. If I am in the food industry, I will look for a software that is specialized for food industries with that the permission and things like that. So it's very important for the customer to find a software that is adapted to his industry, to have experts and brochures related to the industry. The other one is the branding. People buy SAP because it's a safe choice. You won't get fired if you choose SAP because it's solid, everyone knows it in the market, and it's good branding. The other one is the features. The more features you have, the more chance you have to win the deal. So usually large customers, they have a long list of features. Do you do this and that and that and that? And more you check the box, the more chances you have to win the deal. And then we have the technical quality. Is it easy to customize or to develop? Will it take 6 months or 6 years? Then there's the pricing, the lower the better. And the usability, it's new. 5 years ago, nobody cared. The manager were buying ERP based on slides and process and so on. But nowadays, everyone has an iPhone or is used to have good things. So they want quality software for the employees too, not only for the manager. So usability became important. And if we analyze the market, here is the positioning of SAP, one of the leader on the ERP market for the large companies. They are very strong in industries. They have 26 industries. They are in aeronautics, food industries, manufacturing industries, and so on. Very good in branding, at least in their area. You may not know them, but in their area, like ERP World, they are very famous. They're quite good in feature. They do sale, purchase, manufacturing. They go very deep in manufacturing, accounting, and so on. But it's not perfect because the new modern features like e-commerce, social marketing, point of sale, they don't have it. they have to integrate different software. So feature is good, but not perfect. Technical quality is very bad. It's based on old ABAP platform, even SAPANA compared to Postgres is not on par with Postgres. Pricing, we saw it, is very expensive compared to us, so it's quite low. The value of the pricing is low. And the usability, I'll show you that. SCP screenshot. So you get it. It looks like that. So the usability is very bad. And that's the positioning of the main player on the market. And if we do that exercise of trying to map the value of all the players, you will have Microsoft like this, a bit lower in industries and branding, still very good in branding for Microsoft Dynamics. It's a bit better in technical quality because it's cloud at least. Pricing is better, it's less expensive, and UX is a bit better. So that is the profile of Microsoft Dynamics. That is the profile for Oracle NetSuite. And basically, you can map all the players in this system, and you will have the same band. Everyone will fit in the same band like that. Pretty much everyone has the same profile on the market. And if we look at Odoo, we have this. We are very bad in industries. We have no industry web page. So we are, even if we are good like NGOs, we are the leader in NGOs. We work with the top biggest NGOs in the world who use Odoo. But on our website, you won't find a section for industry NGO. We don't have experts dedicated to that. We don't have brochures. So basically, we could say that our strategy per industry is way lower than the others. In branding also, sometimes we think that we are famous because people see our cars. But if you look at the world and the size of the marketing team of the others and things like that, and outside of Belgium, we are pretty much nowhere. We own less than 0.1% of the market, so the branding is very low. Features, we are very good. Not only we do the ERP stuff, but also the point of sale e-commerce, the spreadsheet integration, and so on. Social marketing. Our technology is modern, so it's very fast, whether it's with Odoo Studio or custom development to develop. Technical quality is high. Pricing is super low. That means that the value of our pricing is high. And the usability, it's not perfect. It's not on par with a pure iPad application that does only one thing. But for an ERP, it's very good, much better than the others. And so that is the strategy of Odoo. Let's say, if you follow me or not, if you have to decide where we should over-invest and where we should under-invest, where do you think we should invest in the future? Is it in branding, because we are very bad, we have to compensate that? Or in industries and create industry space to show what we do? Or is it in UX or pricing on quality? Where do you think we should invest in the future? Someone wants to answer? Just to check if you don't sleep. Yeah, go for it. Yeah, perfectly. So you followed me. What matters for us is the tool we provide to the users. Branding is not a tool for the user. It's good to sell more. It helps in a lot of things, but not in our mission to make employees do more in less time. UX does. But there is another reason why we do that, is that if you look at this, one thing is clear in this map, is that we are not better than the others. I mean, we cannot be. We could say, okay, we'll invest in branding and industries and be the best in the world in everything. It's just not possible. I mean, it's not magic. You cannot be the best in everything. It would be a dream and we would lie to ourselves. But the strength of Odoo, the thing that made us success today, is that we are different. All the other players are in the same band, but we are in a completely different value proposition. And by investing in the UX, what we do is to increase our difference. As opposed that if we start to investing more in branding in industries, we will decrease our difference. But our success doesn't come from the fact that we are better. It comes from the fact that we are different and investing that. So in short, what we do, we over invest in the product compared to the others and UX specifically. And we under invest in industry and in branding. That's why you have no branding page, no industry page on our website. And I like to explain that because I don't know if there is account managers or partnership recruiter in the room. Yes, no, yeah. So sometimes you probably had partners who say, but why don't you do brochures? Why don't you invest more billboards in my country? Why don't you do this and this and this and that? And the only answer you could provide to that is to say, we do it because it's a strategy. And you cannot say, no, okay, we'll do brochure, we'll do this, we'll do that. It's a strategy. We decided that we underinvest in marketing so that we can overinvest in UX. And we all benefit from that. And the reason why it works for the partners is because we did that since 10 years. And so usually the right explanation for them is just to explain them. Here is our strategy, here is why we do it, and then they understand, okay, I don't need a brochure anymore. I'm not saying that we don't do marketing. Actually, we have a very, very efficient marketing team. It's just that we do less marketing than the others, but the return on investment on the small we invest is probably much better than the others. The team is very efficient. Clear? And it's the same for industry. Even though we don't have a strategy of industries, there are some industries where we are the leader because we have the product, because we have the partner, all together we are very efficient. And basically, usually our marketing and our strategy is per app. So we want to be the leader of accounting, we want to be the leader of the logistic or the best CRM, the best website builder in the world, and not per industry. We don't have a vision to be the leader in the food market or the aeronautics or manufacturing, because we think that at the end, the generic tools will win. Yeah, so there is partners that focus on industry. So we still have industries and branding efforts. Especially in biomedical, we have very strong partners in Belgium. In pretty much every industry, we have partners dedicated to that. But because it's not pushed by us, it's limited. The effort is limited to what could be a global effort if we would do it ourselves. Yeah, with all the community modules, it's very easy to... there are plenty of modules for industry, so it's very easy for partners to position themselves on an industry. So, if I have to summarize what I said, yeah, I speak very fast. one is that we have, in the future, we won't have a market issue. I mean, the market is big, it's super big. We do less than 0.1% of the market, so we are basically nothing on this market. And even when we think about the market, people think about the value of the market today, like what's the market of the ERP, but our market is not even the market of today. Our market is the 82% of the companies who could not afford something. So it's a big market that nobody started to work on yet. So it's even bigger than what we think it is. So basically, the market is so big that it's not going to be a bottleneck. We'll grow a lot with the market. Competition is not a bottleneck anymore. We have seen it. We are different from all the others. We are succeeding on the SMEs where no other ERPs are really succeeding on SMEs, at least on a global scale. And no issue with the product. The product is years ahead of its time, and we have to continue, of course, if we want to keep that. The only issue we'll have in the future is that it's not easy to go from 1,000 to 2,000 people. It's execution. And if we fail, it's going to be my fault, or your fault too, actually, because it's a thing of people. It's the fact that we all work together, that we'll have plenty of problems as we grow, that we'll have plenty of slippery on the culture of people that behave like they used to behave in their corporate situation before. And it's up to us to be sure that all things goes well as we grow, as we recruit new people, as we get more and more advanced and challenging projects to make things run smooth. So it's actually good news because the success is in our hands. There is no external factor like the market or the competition, but it's still a huge challenge because we are way too small for what we do. And the demand of customers is so big and exploding that we have to scale very fast. Is it clear? Is there any question? So I did in 45 minutes what should have been a 1 hour 20 minutes presentation. So I hope you have questions about this or about anything else. Yep.
I have a question about your slides. Did you write supervise your children?
Yeah. So basically, what I did is I on paper, I told them, I did some square and then I put the word autonomy, blah, blah, blah. And I put all the numbers or the text I wanted and they did the rest. So basically, one of the slides that I like a lot is this one with the small poo. I just wrote, we are living in a shitty period. And I did the rest. I did that on paper.
So they speak English?
Yeah, but I lived 2.5 years in the US. Yeah. Actually, they lived in the US, I was here. And I traveled because at the time we had a lot of issues in Odoo Belgium, the company, so I couldn't. We had issues in the US, and we had to go in the US to fix the issues with the company in the US. So I told my wife and the kids, let's go to the US, we have to help the company grow, and we'll go for there for 2 or 3 years. And then my wife quit her job and in Belgium and moved to the US with the children. And then I had a lot of issues in Belgium. We had no cash anymore. And so I thought, by the way, I couldn't come. So I had to travel, and I was only part-time there, but they were full-time, so they could learn English. Yeah, that's the story. Any other question?
Maybe can you tell us more about the other offices around the...
Yes. One thing that always surprised me about the other offices around the world is that I don't travel a lot, so I don't meet them often. Sometimes after only 4 years, I meet the office for the first time. One thing that always surprised me, and every time we go to one of these offices, is that they have exactly the same culture than us. And I expected that they'd behave differently, and that what we did in Belgium is so strong that they couldn't be the same. But all the offices have exact same culture, the same way of operating. So we did a few things that works very well, like the survival guide that we give to every new employee. We did the same there. So. And the fact that all the companies we have been created by ex-employees of Odoo Belgium. So they came there, they bring the culture. We never recruit external experienced manager, even in Belgium. Pretty much all the managers were the best employee of the team that just became manager. So we did a certain thing to be sure that we keep the culture. And so if you look around and go to the other companies of Belgium, they basically have the same culture. Lot of autonomy, responsibility, evolution of the people. And they have the same way of operating because we have the chance of having only one product, one way to deliver the service, one way to sell, or two, three ways to sell with the direct and indirect, but they replicated all those things. So it's basically, you would see the Odoo Belgium team, but Indian style or American style. But it's very similar in the, of course, there are some cultural aspects, but on the way they operate, it's very similar. It's the same department, same methodology, everything. It's part of our success too. We never talk about it, but when you look at Odoo, it seems very complex. I mean, we do all the application you can imagine. We are growing big and so on. But at the end, one thing we did very well is to keep the company very simple. There is low layers of management. Everyone is open, accessible. We all work the same way. There is only one product for a company of 1,200. It's rare to only have one product. Even the product, it feels like it's complex, but actually the number of lines of code is very low. There is 250,000 lines of code in Odoo, all the modules, accounting, manufacturing, e-commerce, everything, 250,000 lines. If you compare Magento Commerce or PrestaShop to e-commerce open source, they have 2 million. 2 million for Magento, 1 million for PrestaShop, and they only do e-commerce. So even that, you may think that the product is very evolved because it doesn't fit, but we succeeded to keep the code simple. And because of that, we could replicate easily and grow faster on that base. Any other question?
Yes, is there a strategy regarding the direction that Odoo will take? Like we have a lot of different apps at the moment. There are sometimes new apps that have been created from one product to another. Is there a focus to be done on some markets or not? So obviously you explained that there is this general view, but...
So your question is, what are the main focus app or sector that we focus on? So the main thing is usability. It's improving the existing app. So our core focus today in the R&D department, it's not about building new apps, it's about improving the existing apps. And it's easy to say because we already do everything in apps, so it's already very large to improve what we do. Usability is very complex to explain. I had a similar question in the pre-thinking group. Because usability is not like I will develop a big new feature. The usability is to make things perfect, faster and better and so on. And usually it's a sum of 1,000 small details. It's not like developing one big feature. And I will show you the kind of details we do. For instance, here, I think it's here. That's part of what the product owners do, is that they analyze the way people use the software, and we analyze where they don't understand, where they lose time, or where they get frustrated, so that we improve the software. And here we add a use case. So we ask someone, and we recorded the way you use the system, we ask someone to create a reception from Apple of two iPhones. So you just receive two iPhones. And to record that in the system, and we record it, and we analyze the way he operates. And you will see what he does. He goes to the reception. He will select Apple, so that's, for now it's correct. And then he will add the two iPhones that he will receive. So he set an iPhones. And here you already have a problem. You see the done quantity field, it's read-only. So technically it's not read-only. Once he will have put the product, it's gonna be writable so that you can put the quantity you want to receive. But now as he sees the product and he starts writing, he thinks that it's read-only, the done quantity. So he selects iPhone, it's zero. Now it's not anymore read-only, but he did not notice it. And because we ask him to receive two products, he's creating another line. Because he thinks that in order to receive two products, he has to create two lines because he couldn't put the quantity. And of course, when he tries to do that, he will have an exception. Did I move too fast? And now he will create the second line, add a line. With another iPhone. And what he's doing here is actually to register two iPhones of zero quantity each, so we received zero. And these are the kind of things, if we make all these details perfect, we will save time to train the user, but also save time to a worker who once in a while will do a mistake, and then you will have an inventory that will cost money and time to people. And that's the kind of things they do, is they make things that exist are perfect. That's one thing, usability. The other thing is that we do a lot of focus on accounting, localization in all the countries. We do a lot in the website builder because the open source website builder area, which is dominated by WordPress, who has 64% of the market, it's quite old technologies. If you look at Magento, e-commerce is very bloated. PrestaShop is quite old too. WordPress is okay, but it's not on par with Shopify for the e-commerce or with Wix and Weebly for the website builder part. So there is a massive opportunity to come with a modern, I would say, website builder and CMS on that area for open source players. And the majority of the market is for the open source players, for the integrators and marketing agency. So that's one of our big priority too, is to build a new generation of CMS and website builder. So we invest a lot in the website builder and e-commerce, which is a big market. It's probably as big, even bigger than the ERP market. And so we work on pretty much every application, but it's difficult to explain because it's just improving what's existing. Any other question?
So, SMEs market is so big and like, the focus is so clear with the ease of use and the user experience, why the decision of also entering the corporate market?
Yeah, it's a good question. So why do we defocus ourselves? We pushed back on this for long. We could have done that 5 to 10 years ago because the product is very good for corporate, but we didn't do it. We started to do it 2 years ago because the opportunity was so massive and they came to us. It's not like we have to chase them and invest a lot in marketing, in sales. We don't even have to invest. The corporate, they want and they need to do. And because we had all these leads coming and people to say calling us, and because we didn't have to invest in marketing and in the product because the product does everything they need, it was just about setting the sales team and the service. So the defocus is not that big compared to the value it brings. And the value that it brings now is even surprising. It's much better than what we thought. The team is growing super fast on this market.
Does it bring also a lot of customization and like?
So there is way more customization. So the technical service team, we had to recruit developers that we assign on larger projects. It's still the other way. So we still are in line with our methodology of sticking to the standard and so on. So we develop maybe 5 to 7 times less than traditional players on this market, even for the corporate. So we are still extremely agile and fast to deploy. But of course, it requires more consultants and more developers. Typically, on a large company, I would say 1,000, 2,000 employees to deploy everything on Odoo, the ratio is 50-50. 50% of the team is developer, 50% of the project team is consultant. Where on the small and mid-size, it's 80% consultant versus 20% developers.
And is it like a solution for the industries work that you don't really need to focus if you
can? No. So yeah, we do industries because we sell to NGOs, we sell to manufacturing. But in terms of marketing and in terms of products, we want to continue focusing. We cannot win all the battle. Our battle is to be the best CMS in the world or the best accounting or the best CRM per application, not per industry. That doesn't mean we don't sell to industries. We're actually very efficient on a lot in industries, but we are efficient in the same way that iPhone has been efficient on the mobile market. You know, before iPhone, there were the smartphone for the corporate, Raspberry. BlackBerry, that were for the corporate, and then Nokia for the consumer. And then it was two different markets, and then the generic guy came, and iPhone and Android after, and made the market unique. I believe it's going to be the same. I believe with the maturity of accounting system and CRM, that will win industries, because at the end, accounting is more or less the same for every industry, CRM is the same. There are some details in the logistics and some details in the way you operate. But with community modules, we cover them. But by focusing on being the best accounting or the best manufacturing, we'll win those industries. And we won't have to defocus on doing marketing or product development for industries. Any other question? I have a question for you. Is it useful or you already knew everything? That kind of presentation. In other words, should I do it with the new people we recruit later on or not?
I think it's always interesting to have a presentation from the founders.
Yeah, don't tell the CEO. You know, you remember these two things? One thing, in which team are you?
Support.
Support, it's okay. Well, in the sales team, you know, the manager of the sales team is Sébastien. And if you want to excite Sébastien, there is one thing he really hates. Tell him that he is your N plus two. He really hates that. Every time someone tells him you are my N plus two, he say, okay, come back to PwC.
He's been there for like
longer. Yeah.
So more than anyone in the company, and also because most of the things you've explained we've already heard, but it's a different point of view and a different way of explaining it too. So
yeah. And sometimes we need to remind ourselves also. Maybe. One thing which is important at Odoo, I didn't talk about that, but speak about the anecdote of Sébastien, is that we consider that the manager are the service of the team. So you shouldn't perceive your manager. Sometimes the new people, they are afraid of talking to the manager or they think that the CEO is the CEO or things like that. And I see it. I see a lot of new people that are afraid of talking to me directly. You shouldn't see it that way. Actually, the team leader and so on, they are the service of the team. All we do is to be sure that everyone evolves rather than try to direct people. And it's the way it should be, so everyone should feel comfortable with that. Any other question? No? Okay, thank you.